Well, there is nothing quite like this occasion. Welcome to the UEFA Champions League final. The best two teams in Europe this season preparing to go head-to-head for the crown. This is Derek Ray in the commentary position, and I'm joined as always on these big occasions by the former Arsenal and England defender, Lee Dixon. It is Manchester United versus Arsenal.
Well, it's an absolute pleasure, Derek, to be here. Very, very lucky indeed to be broadcasting to millions and millions of people, let alone watching this fantastic game. I'm sure the players are a little bit nervous as well with that audience looming in the background, tuning in on their televisions. It's going to be a great night. I'm very excited to be here. Hopefully, we get the game that this tournament deserves.
Manchester United have chosen this particular shape, and you tend to know what you're going to get tactically from this team. High pressing.
Well, high pressing, high energy. I played this system at Arsenal many a year under George Graham. It doesn't half work when it works well. Sometimes you can just get exposed to the back, but they've got it down to a T, to be fair.
And this is it, the final of the UEFA Champions League. It's where everyone wants to be. Only two sides can accomplish that feat. And Lee, it's going to be fascinating to see what happens tonight.
Well, it is. It's the big party. It will be after the game. But as players, it's very difficult to try and stay in the moment and not get carried away. And that's the job of the senior players in the dressing room, but also the coach. Look around your team, see the calm ones, have a word with them, get them to pass the message on. Stick to the game plan, go out and win the game.
And so the starting 11 for Arsenal. Bernd Leno stands between the posts. Thomas Partey starts with Granit Xhaka in the centre of the pitch. And leading the line today, Alexandre Lacazette. Rashford. Edinson Cavani now. Bruno Fernandes. That's the kind of shielding play you expect from him. Excellent block. Well, if there's one man who can be a match winner, then surely it is Jadon Sancho. Lee, what do you expect to see from him?
Well, I love watching him. He's got quick feet, quick mind. He wants you to come close to you so he can get past you. So as defenders normally stand off him, and then he's got more time to pick the pass he wants, and he normally finds the best one.
Cavani. Promising attack this. And return to Cavani. Bruno Fernandes. And unable to keep possession. The high press was very much on. Cavani. On to Sancho. Danger averted. Lovely first touch. That wasn't easy. Really closing him down. Arsenal's free kick here. Martin Ødegaard. Thomas just couldn't keep the ball. Shaw still passing it around with authority. He's using his strength to good effect. Can he put them in front? In it goes for Manchester United, who are in the driving seat in this final.
Well, when you've got a game plan and you go a goal behind, Manchester United in front, you have to change that game plan. Well, here it is again. You're trained from a young age to get in those sort of positions, and never in any real doubt he finished that. Cool and composed.
Arsenal restart the game then, and they have work to do as they try to wipe out that last goal. Good strength to keep the ball. Well, he likes to run at them. Fred. McTominay. And David Luiz gets in the way. Can they hit on the break? Will it be sufficiently imaginative? Well, he's given us away. Bellerin. Saka had a chance to whip it in here. Regained possession. And a throw in it's going to be. Thomas. And Arsenal now find themselves in potentially a dangerous position. Bellerin. And here's Partey. Hector Bellerin. Saka. Well, they keep passing away. Granit Xhaka. It needs an accurate cross. Very clear who got the last touch. So a corner coming up. And firing it into the area. Saka. And it's with David Luiz now. And the fourth official confirming that we'll have one additional minute. Marcus Rashford. Edinson Cavani now. Fred. And there it is, the half-time whistle. Into the second half then, in this battle for Champions League glory. Gabriel. Thomas now. Bukayo Saka. That strong play here on the shielding front, getting the better of his opponent. Can he play it in? Bellerin. And now Xhaka. Lacazette. Can they square the game? Crucial intervention just then amid impending danger. That's how to rob them of possession.
United struggling in terms of possession, but they won't mind. They're winning this game. And why? Because their counter-attack is absolutely fantastic.
Could cross it in here. Still on for him. It comes to absolutely nothing. Wan-Bissaka. More than decent this from United. Setting off perhaps a little bit too much here. Cavani. And he's taken it away. Cavani. Fred. It's with McTominay. Well, let's get more details on the injury situation from our pitchside reporter, Jeff Shreves.
He landed really heavily on his shoulder there. You can see the discomfort he's in, but he's a tough guy. I think he'll carry on.
Cheers, Jeff. Well, both teams have had substitutes warming up, and now both will rely on their respective benches.
McTominay entra con il numero 6, Paul Pogba. Sostituzione per l'Arsenal. Lascia il campo con il numero 9, Alexandra.
We're now inside the final 20 minutes of the game.
Con il numero 14, Pierre-Emerick.
Rashford. Here's Cavani. Rashford. And here's Fred. Pogba. And it was a very good-looking move, but alas, no end product. Well, the ball lost here. Well, in the second half, trailing, albeit by a small margin. How should they be viewing this task, Lee?
Well, Arsenal haven't been at the best for me. Little off colour in all departments, but they're still in this game. We used to say on the pitch, if we were losing near the end, we'll always get one more chance. Let's see if they do.
Shaw. Pure ball control. Strong but fair tackle. Bodies forward and the break looks on. Gabriel Martinelli. The clock is against Arsenal, but what can they pull out of the fire here? Dangerous looking attack. Xhaka. Fractionally offside.
Un giocatore in campo per il Manchester United. Fuori con il numero 12, Edinson Cavani. In campo con il numero 9, Anthony Martial.
Inside the final 2 minutes of this contest. Marcus Rashford. Well, adding up all the stoppages, we will have 2 extra minutes. Thomas. Gabriel Martinelli. It's with Gabriel. Martin Odegaard. And now the whistle they all wanted to hear. Manchester United have painted the Champions League red. Losers and winners. The story here. United have done it.
Well, arguably the biggest club side in the world win the biggest club competition in the world. A great team effort. This really is a team effort. From 1 to 11, every one of them have done their job tonight.
It's a proud moment for any footballer. They know what's about to occur, the presentation of old Big Ears, Lee.
Yeah, I'm not so sure that's a very nice title for that trophy. It's a brilliant trophy, and the captain now is going to get possibly the best moment of his career, the chance to lift the Champions League.
Manchester United have the cup.
Feelings that these players get now might never be repeated again. Enjoy every moment.
And the party continues as the players celebrate with their adoring supporters who've made the trip here.
Enjoy it, boys. Stay on that pitch as long as you possibly can.
United, a team with a rich history in this competition, going all the way back to 1968 when they beat...